If you don't know where you've landed, my name is Sabrina Gebhardt. I'm a lifestyle photographer and educator, and I am in Fort Worth, Texas, and I come on here weekly and do live Q&A with you guys. I drop a question box on Wednesdays and you guys ask questions. So all of the questions this week and every week come directly from you. So it makes them a mixed bag of questions and we get to discuss a lot of really fun things. Do you use presets or do you hand edit? I'm team preset all the way, okay? Hand editing is for some artists, it is not for me. I do not open Photoshop unless it is an absolute emergency situation. And in over 10 years, almost 11 years of doing that, there is rarely an emergency situation, okay? I am a Lightroom editor all the way. I have presets that I have created to fit most of my situations. Creating a preset is super duper easy, whether you create one or two presets to use on every session or whether you create an individual preset per session, that's up to you, but presets create consistency. That is the number one way you are going to get consistently edited work across the board is a preset. So 100% you need to do that. I talked more about presets. You guys, was it last week's Q&A or the week before? Very recently, we had a longer discussion of presets. So if you go back through the past lives and open up to read the caption, you'll see every question discussed listed in the caption. Find the one that talks about editing and then watch that one because you'll see me talk a lot more about presets there. I can't keep up with social media or editing. How do you balance that? Okay, so I'm gonna give you four things. First of all, before I give you these four things, I am going to commiserate with you. It's hard. Did you notice how I said, how do you balance editing and social media? I didn't say, how do you balance shooting or emailing or blogging? Okay. It's something that a lot of people, when they start a photography business, they don't realize. Editing and social media take up so much dang time. And when you get behind on these things, like you're on the struggle bus and you feel overwhelmed and you feel like you're drowning and it's a lot. So I'm telling you that you are not alone. So many people struggle with this so I'm gonna give you four things to try and help you out, okay? Again, this is, I can't keep up with social media or editing. How do you balance that? So here we go. First of all, I want you to work in a focused block schedule system, okay? You've probably heard of block scheduling. You've probably heard me talk about it before. And here's what I want you to know. You don't have to block schedule every hour of every day, of every week, of every month. Like, that's not the point. I want you to block schedule the big chunks of things that you're struggling with, like editing and social media. Those are two things that are amazing when worked into a focused block schedule, okay? So what does that mean? So for me, I do all of my social media for the week, sometimes for the month, at one time, in a huge chunk of time, and I do editing in a huge chunk of time, okay? And then there are days where I don't do any social media or any editing, okay? So what it looks like for me is Tuesdays are generally my editing days, the whole day. I don't open anything else. I don't check my emails. I don't get on social media a whole lot unless I'm like on a break. I am editing all day. The other tabs are closed. I've got, you know, some sort of focused music in my ears. I'm hopped up on caffeine and I am powering through the editing. Okay. That's the day that I'm sending off galleries. That's the day that I'm, you know, culling through and getting all my sneak peeks ready from sessions from the week before. Tuesdays are my heavy hitting editing day. And do you know that because I'm not trying to focus on doing a little bit of this and a little bit of this and a little bit of this and bouncing around, I am able to get through all of the editing from a whole week in one day because that's all I'm doing. I'm not distracted. Okay, so I do the same thing for social media. I also do the same thing for blogging. I will set aside, it depends on how long I'm trying to plan for, but let's say for social media, I'm planning for the whole week. I'll set aside 2 or 3 hours and I will map out what images I'm going to use, what the topics are gonna be. If I have time to write out captions, I'm doing that. I'm getting my hashtags planned. I am literally doing all of it at one time without looking at the other tabs, without being distracted and doing other things, like head down doing the work. That is focused block scheduling, and that's where you are able to maximize your productivity. So most photographers try and dabble in a little bit of everything every day. They check their emails, they send some invoices, they book some clients, they cull through some images, they try and work on a little bit of a gallery, they'll hop on social media, they'll think of something to post that day. You know, they're bouncing all over the place. And not to mention, they're doing a bunch of other things in between. Maybe they've got school pickup and drop off. Maybe they've got laundry to flip. Maybe they've got a meeting. Maybe they're going to scout out a new venue. There's all these other things. And when you are bouncing around between all of these things, you're never really getting anything done. Okay, so I want you to try focused block scheduling where you focus on one task for several hours. Okay, so this really works well with editing, social media, and blogging. So I highly recommend that. The second thing is stop trying to multitask. That's the whole point of the focused block scheduling, but I'm just gonna reiterate this. Stop trying to multitask. When you're trying to do all the tasks every day, you're like getting everything done a quarter of the way, or maybe something's not done at all. You've got to prioritize. And another thing that goes with the multitasking is when you say to yourself, I'm going to sit down and I'm going to get through this gallery today. I'm going to just edit all the way through this gallery and that's all I'm going to do. When you have your phone sitting over here, or when you have a bunch of tabs open, or when you're getting email pings coming in, that's not really focused. You're multitasking without realizing it. You're paying attention to the notifications over here and the notifications over there, and you're getting distracted. Put your blinders on, turn everything else off, close all the tabs, put your phone face down so you're not getting the notifications, turn the notifications on your computer off. Really, truly focus on what you are doing without the distractions. Number three, I want you to create some sort of repurposing content plan. This is gonna really help you with social media, okay? Stop trying to reinvent the wheel, okay? You don't need to have this incredible caption every single day, okay? Do a great caption 4 times a month where it's really deep and there's bullet points and there's all these different things, and then repurpose that stuff into a bunch of other little captions, okay? So for example, if you look at my post in my feed from last night, it is something about what to wear for family sessions, okay? And there's like, I think there's 3 points, like number one, number two, number three, okay? So that's not a long in-depth post by any means, but if I wanted to make it last longer, give it some longevity and repurpose it, I could take number one and turn it into a whole post. I could take number two and turn it into a whole post. I could take number three and turn it into a whole post. Not exact word for word, but take the meat of it and extend it into something else. That is content repurposing. That is taking some great ideas and making it last as long as possible. Okay. If you don't know about content repurposing, there's a whole bunch of stuff on the internet about it. I teach about it in my course, The Organized Photographer. I am going to be speaking to it a little bit for my talk at Reset Conference later this month. It is something I'm really passionate about, but make your social media, your blogging, your newsletters, all of your content creation work for you. Okay. Take the struggle away from, what am I going to post on Instagram today? Like, that's half the battle. Take something that you know was well received already, reword it, tweak it, take part of it, take a quote from it, whatever. Make it work for you, okay? So the number four thing for question that you are struggling with balancing social media and editing and all the things, is hire somebody to help you edit. I do it. Tons of other people do it. It's the best money I spend in my business. I will, every single session, I edit between 3 and 15 images, depends on how long and how big their gallery is gonna be, but I will edit sneak peeks so that I have them for social media immediately. They also act as a guide for what I want the whole gallery to look like. I send it off to my editor at the Image Salon and poof, they take care of the whole thing for me. They send it back when it's done and I just go through them very quickly and make maybe, you know, a tweak here, a tweak there, and then I download and I send it off. I literally save hours every week. I save probably 10 hours a week by sending off my editing. If you are really struggling that much, hire and outsource your editing. Hire somebody. Whether you go through Upwork to find an actual human, or whether you go through the Image Salon or another service, there are plenty out there. Get help where you need it, okay? So I hope this was valuable to you guys. We covered so much today. If you found this valuable, would you share it to your Insta stories? The replay is gonna be in my feed in just a hot minute. And then would you share it to your stories and tag me? I would love to know that this was valuable, and I would love for you to pass this information on to your photographer friends who might want it too. I will see you guys next week. Bye.